Hello and welcome to this tutorial on creating a confetti particle system in Unity with only default assets. Here first I will be starting by creating a new particle system by moving our demo particle system aside so that we will be creating the new one from scratch. And to create a particle system you can go to hierarchy, right click, effects and choose particle system. Here we have our new particle system appeared in front of us. So first thing, let's change our particle. And we can change the particles in the particle system's render module. In the renderer module, we have render mode. And we need to set the render mode to the mesh so that we can use meshes as our particle. And the mesh that we will be using is a plane mesh. And using this mesh, we will be having this flat particles that we can move however we like when we apply all the changes of these particles. And here we don't see our particles very clearly if you ask me. And we can change it by changing the material of these particles to something opaque. And using a white material helps us that when we apply a new color, we will directly see the new color that is applied. And I choose to use Sprite's default material that Unity provides because it's default assets. Now that I have my confettis a little bit solidified, but they're too big to be a confetti, they're like papers. And to change the size of the confettis that's when they're spun, I'm going back to my particle system module. And in this module, we have start size. You can play with the 3D start size if you want your game objects to be not squares but rectangles. You can use this, but in this tutorial, we will be using square particles. And if I were to set the particle system to a smaller size like 0.5, they get smaller, but again, there will be no variety between the particles, and variety is never a bad thing in the game. So let's use some randomness by clicking the down arrow next to the input file and choosing random between two constants. And the second constant should be a smaller value, which is 0.01, and the newly particles will be between the sizes 0.01 and 0.1. Now we set the size of the particles. Let's go and set the shape of the particle system. We can set it in the shape module. At the default, we have the shape of cone, but we will be finding the particles in a box area. So let's go and select the box shape, and we will be scaling the shape of the particles from the gizmos here, and we will be scaling it in the x axis and z axis. After scaling down, there is one thing that is odd about our particle system. We have a particle system that defies the gravity. To change it, we will be rotating the game object of the particle system by setting its x rotation to 90 degrees, and it will be flip it from its minus 90 degrees rotation. And its placement is very nicely done. Now that our particles are falling down, let's go and make them fall down even more frequently. Let's go and change their emission rate in the emission module. So rate over time gives us the number of particles emitted per second. And let's go and increase it to some value like 60. Now we have more frequent emission of particles, and our particles are starting to look a little bit like confettis. Maybe start to give them a more confetti look by changing its color. So, starting color decides what color will be set to new emitted particles, and I will be using random color mode to select a start color. And random color gives us a gradient UI, and you can fill up the colors in the gradient, and the game engine will be set the color with however you tilt it. I will be setting the colors with very straightforward way. Okay, colors are set. Now there are two modes in gradient editor in Unity. If you were to use blend mode, you will get the blended areas between two colors that you pinned in the gradient. But if you were to use fixed mode, you will only get the colors that you set in the gradient. And there will be no blends, only these five colors that we set. To get a more color variety, let's use blend mode. Now our particles have the colors attained to them, but their movement is odd now. So let's fix their movement. First, let's start with the speed. Each particle is falling down with the same speed, but when you use confettis, it is not the story. Each confetti particle falls down with different speeds. So let's give them again a random value between two constants. Either let's start with the 4 value and between 4 and 8. So the speed will be vary between the values 4 and 8, and it will have a more variety action. And now that we set the start speed, let's go and set the start rotation and angular rotation through when they are falling down. So we don't need to set a rotation at the start because we can choose a random rotation while they are falling down. And we choose that random rotation in rotation over lifetime module of particle system. Here all the particles are given angular velocity value of 45. Again they will be rotating in the same speed. So let's go and add some randomness to here as well. And this time let's make it 45 and 180. When I set these values, I'm not satisfied with the results. And when I use separate axes, it's a more satisfying effect if you ask me. I don't exactly know, but I believe it gives more variety to choose from between the values while they are rotating and falling down. And this is it for creating the particle system by using only default assets in Unity. For a little bit performance optimization, we may create a scenario that when the particles pass through the ground, they will be killed. We can achieve this by using particle systems triggers module. So when the particles collide with the selected colliders that we'll be setting right now, some events are fired and some actions are taken. Here, for example, when the particle is inside and just collides with the collider, it is set to be killed. Personally, I prefer to kill my particles after it went through the ground. So I will be using exit event and set the action to kill the particle. Here you will see when they are just out of the ground, they are killed. So for this to work, you need to set your collider to be a trigger. So keep that in mind. And this is it for this video. If there's a point not clear, please let me know in the comments down below. And I have just created bursts. Bursts also gives a nice confetti effect. So in the future videos, I am planning to do one on burst effect and again using with confettis. If you're interested in that kind of video, consider subscribing to my channel and mentioning of the subscribing to my channel with the 50 subscribers milestone. And I'm very happy about it. And for the next milestones, please consider subscribing because there will be more videos coming like this one or the ones that already here, like simple 3D mechanics, some tips and tricks, and some interesting experiments, and also some VR videos I have been creating for some time now. And if you're interested in that, please consider subscribing, and let's go to the 100 subscribers and have another confetti video there. Okay, this is it. The next confetti video will be up when we have 100 subscribers in this channel. After the channel plug, after the subscription plug, I want to plug it again. If you like this video, please consider press like button and subscribe to this channel, because there will be more videos coming on their way. And this is it for now. I hope to see you in the next exploration. And bye bye.